I'm done.
We're going to stick to basketball, though, for this.
I couldn't do dinner last night, man. I had some. You know what?
But you're real when you called and said you couldn't make it.
Yeah.
Most people don't do that.
Mama wanted to go early, so she's my priority.
And she run the show.
Heck, I cancel plans all the time. You have respect for that?
Hey,
I love that.
You could have came, Jenna, anytime.
That's great. The most anticipated NCAA tournament debut has to be that of Zion Williamson, best player on the best team at 6'7", 285. The projected number one overall pick is ready to go. Steven Jackson, how does Zion's game translate to the NBA? You look at a player like this, the athlete that he is.
Body-wise, athleticism-wise, he's ready. He has a lot of work to do on his game. The kid is an athlete. Right now, he's just jumping over everybody. He's stronger than everybody. So he's going to dominate. When he gets to the NBA, everybody on the court's that size. Everybody on the court's that strong. Everybody's an athlete in the NBA. So it's going to be a different, but he's still going to be a dominant NBA player because of his ability at that age. He's going to continue to grow and his confidence. I think the biggest thing about him, he has the confidence of a number one pick of a guy that's going to succeed in the NBA. And that's what you need. A lot of guys come in the NBA that get drafted high, but they don't have the confidence. They really don't believe in themselves. With this kid, he has the confidence. I think he's going to do great in the NBA.
Steven, you remember when Blake Griffin came into the league?
Mm-hmm.
Game was not refined.
Right.
Didn't have a jump shot at all. He was an athlete. Now, he's taller than Zion, about 3, maybe almost 4 inches taller than Zion. And he was considered strong by NBA standards as a rookie. He's not as big as Zion. Blake's first year gave you 23 and 12. Mm-hmm. I think Zion's already a better defensive player than Blake was when he first came into the league. He might not be as instantly dominant offensively because the size does matter. He is. You said there's going to be everyone in the NBA is his strength. I disagree with you on that. I think the moment he walks into the NBA, he's going to be top 5 percentile of strength. But the height is going to be a big difference now. 6'7 is plenty tall for a college player. For an NBA player, he's going to be undersized for the position that he's playing, certainly until he learns to shoot. Mm-hmm. But his ability to play weak side defense and his ability to dominate you in transition, if he's on a team that plays at a fast pace with even a halfway decent coach, I think he can be a guy that walks in the league and gives you 20 a game. I think, and won't be a liability defensively. And you know this, one thing that gets overrated when people come into the league is the way rookies get exploited on the defensive end. Mm-hmm. Almost every rookie that comes in is not even an average defender. They're bad defenders. Right. He's going to have that going for him in the positive
and direction. Most of the time, the reason why they're poor defensive is about heart. It's about attitude. But then they don't have the size. So he's not going to have to worry about that. He's a willing defender right now. Because I watched Ja play last night. He's going to have to get better on the defensive end.
Yeah.
I mean, he was giving the dude 8 feet. Like, he was like, hey, you out there. Like, because it's not really beat into them. I think Zion, that's one of the things where he can make an instant impact. The one thing I would be aware of, because to me, he's a tweener player. He's between a person like Gilchrist, who came out of Kentucky, didn't have an offensive shot.
Still
wait 1 second. Yeah. And still doesn't.
Still don't.
And Blake Griffin. But the thing about Blake, when Blake was at this time in college, he was a better offensive player than Zion, by far. Like, he could do more things offensively than Zion. Now, Zion was a better athlete. Then Blake had a year off. He had that red shirt year.
And that certainly helped him.
So those numbers you're talking about, 23 and 12.
I don't think he would have done that if it would have been his true rookie.
And we shouldn't expect that from Zion. Because I can guarantee he won't get 23 and 12.
And the 12 rebounds to me is going to be the way harder number. I think he's going to be 20-some points as a rookie, especially because he's on a team that's going to need it. But the 12 rebounds, that's what differentiated Blake's rookie year was. You don't see rookies that aren't true centers. DeAndre Ayton's doing something similar, but he's playing the 5 at all times.
But the thing with Zion is, look how much he's improved the last 2 months of playing basketball. So he will continue to get better. He's got to add some ball handling. Because if you look at NBA on the offensive end. Man, it's about ball handling, being able to get to a spot, and being able to shoot. Those are the two skill sets that I have seen over the last 20 years. The athletes today, they're not better, but let me tell you something. They got more skill. They can handle it better, and they can show enough shoot the rock better than any other time in modern basketball.
Yeah, he definitely has to work on his shot. But then again, I'm going to say some of the stuff that you said about LeBron. He got to drop some weight. He got to drop a little weight. That's not going to work for him. If you see, even with Boogie, Boogie didn't slim down. Guys like that, especially in the NBA with the game changing, when you got 5 and 4 men out there shooting threes and taking it off the dribble, you have to be able to guard that. And I think he's going to have a problem with that when he first gets in the league, but he's definitely a pro.
So tell me why. Do you think he has to drop weight because you think it can lead to injury? Or you think he needs to drop weight because you think it'll make him more explosive? It feels to me like the reason he's such a one of one athlete that I've ever seen is that size with that explosion.
Remember, this is college. He's going to be in the NBA next year. It's a whole different ball game. And guys are faster. Guys his size are faster. Guys his size are probably just more athletic than him. So it's going to be a culture shock to him because the talent he's playing against
is different. When you're that young, you don't know your true fight weight. I know when Larry Fitzgerald, man, he was huge. He's like, Uncle Chris, man, I think I'm going to be bigger than you. So it's like, man, you can't gauge it off of me. I remember working with Vince Carter when he was a young player and other athletes. That ideal fight weight, when you are young, man, you want it to be as little as possible. Man, Charles Barkley made a huge mistake early in his career trying to play like that with all the weight through his midsection and through his legs. He's got a different type of body. So Jack is on it as far as, man, he's probably eating all kinds of fast food and stuff. Now, if you're going to be a multi-million-dollar player, all that's going to change. He could tighten that up, and it would make him more explosive.
So let's talk about another player who's probably going to get ready and have to change his game or maybe his body a little bit for the NBA, and that's Ja Morant. I don't know if you got a chance to see what he did last night. Yesterday was just spectacular. How NBA ready do you think he is?
You know, like you said, just is all his body. He has the same mold as Russ. Same athleticism, they're the same height.
Ooh. Okay, you said something there.
Oh, yeah, no, they do the exact same thing. When you have a point guard that has that motor, that's athletic, and that size, he can be a Russ Westbrook, and he's showing you that. How many guys have had triple-doubles? Four guys have triple-doubles in the tournament. So, he's one of them. Doing it last night, so it's special.
Well, listen, we were talking about this in the early morning meeting about the Russ Westbrook comparison. I don't think Ja is quite the athlete Russ is, because Russ, even by NBA standards, there was a 3-year period where I think he was the best raw athlete in the league. Ja's an elite athlete, not that. But I think Ja's got better court vision than Russ. I think Ja's a better – Russ is a good passer. I think Ja will be an elite passer at the next level.
Both of them. If you have a triple-double in the league, you're an elite passer.
Well, he's a willing passer. What I'm seeing for Ja Morant averaging 10 assists per game in college when no one else is even averaging 8, that to me that's on the level it's absolutely special.
It's also how Murray State runs their offense. It's kind of set up. He's a gifted passer, but it's set up the way that they run those sets and everything is for him to be able to generate. But Russ, at this stage, Ja is a better scorer.
Yes.
Now, his athleticism, unlike Jack, man, he matches it as far as Russ, because he can do some things that Russ couldn't do at this age. Both of them late bloomers, too. Russ not recruited, highly in, and he hit that growth spurt later where he started to fill into his body. But that jump shot, man, Russ can't outshoot him now.
Nah. Agree. No, that's what the only thing, and we can disagree on we're talking about 98th percentile athleticism, 94th. It's in the margins. The part that is so exciting about Ja Morant is that first step. That first step combined with being an adequate shooter. He's not a great shooter yet, but he's an adequate shooter. And that court vision, now you're talking a very, very special player. And so I think he didn't need to do much to make himself a lock top 5 pick. I think he asserted himself last night as he's going to be the first player taken after Zion. And whoever, when they get to the draft lottery and there's two teams left, it's not going to be this, you mentioned Michael Gilchrist earlier. That was a huge bummer. When it was Anthony Davis, someone's getting Anthony Davis, someone's going to get Michael Kidd Gilchrist. And it's like, you got to be kidding me. That won't happen in this year's draft. Even as much as people want Zion, whoever the consolation prize being Ja Morant is one hell of a consolation prize.
You draft a guy like Gilchrist, you need to look at your people, your scouts, and see who's picking the players for your team. That's horrible. but this kid here, I think a lot of teams are looking at him, not only his game, but his basketball IQ. How many kids in college basketball have an IQ like this kid? And that's why he can make so much stuff happen on the court.
Good point.
Because he's thinking ahead of the game. Mm-hmm. His mind is already in the NBA.
All right, we got to take a break. Steven, we'll see you later in the show. Coming up, what makes